such a fighting place. Oh,
rejoicing.
Oh, and I'm living and moving, dwelling in you, you shine. I'm living and moving and dwelling in you, you shine. I am living and moving and dwelling in you, you shine. I'm living and moving and dwelling in you. For you are my dwelling place, Lord, you are. Lord, you are my dwelling place. Lord, you are my abiding place. Lord, you are my dwelling place. Lord, you are my abiding place. I am living and moving and dwelling in you. I'm living and moving and dwelling in you. I'm living and moving and dwelling in you. Generation. In every generation, God, I'll strengthen our salvation. I'll strengthen our soul. I'll strengthen our salvation. I'll strengthen our soul. I'll strengthen our salvation in every generation. Lord, you are our dwelling place. But you Lord Jesus, we worship you. Just sing that with me. Lord Jesus, we worship you. Say it again. Lord Jesus, we worship you. By the Holy Ghost. By the Holy Ghost. In spirit and in truth. In spirit and in truth. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my moments. Take my moments and my days. Let them flow in ceaseless prayer. Let them flow, Lord. Let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my will and make it thine. It shall be no longer
Just sing that with me. Just one more time, and just believing that Father would do some kind of a miracle on our behalf. We find all of our thoughts and all of our life and all of our purpose so united with His that He can do everything He's wanting to do in and through us. Lord, take and make it shall be. It shall be no longer mine. Take my heart. Take my heart. It is thine own. It shall be thy royal throne. Oh, it shall be thy royal throne. This song was written by a preacher's daughter and about 1860 during the apostolic holiness movement and revival took place in Europe and a great impact United States of America. We pray in God in Jesus' name that there comes such a move, such a mighty blast of the Spirit of the living God upon this nation again that we might take our place among all those that stand around His throne and become a beacon to the nations through the blessing of the living God as this nation is shaken by the power of the Holy Spirit. Yesterday morning, I woke up just singing the song, God Bless America. Saying, oh God, what does it take to shake the churches? Not the White House. Not the political system. God didn't create the political system to deal with the social and moral evils of a society. So what will it take to shake the churches of America that we might awaken once again into a place of complete and total surrender to You? Then should the sinner be converted and transgressors taught His way. I'm telling you right now, my family's been preachers in the United States of America since 1630. We don't need anybody to tell us what our history is. We know what our history is. We know why our parents came here, our grandparents, great-grandparents. God purposed us to stand up in these last days with a strong word from heaven, with a glorious anointing that shines like a light unto the nations. We're going to do it again. Watch. Watch, we're going to do it again. You're going to be shaken because it begins with you. It doesn't begin. So many people sit around and talk about how bad things are going. When you and I get right, when you and I let God do it His way, everything changes. I'm so blessed to have our dear friends and family, Brother Tysto and Brother Yun, the heavenly man. We part of the heavenly family. Hallelujah. If you didn't know it, that's who you are. You are seated in a heavenly realm. It's not a position. It's a reality. You're born into it. Amen. How many people here have been born by the Spirit of the living God? You've been born of the Spirit of God. If you've not been born of the Spirit of God, I want you to know, Father has got an engraved invitation for you. He's engraved it for you in the blood of Jesus. All you have to do is simply call upon the most powerful name that has ever been given, whereby men might be delivered, transformed. That is the name of Jesus. Father's looking for some people who don't want to live in this world under the dictatorship of a satanic realm and satanic power, but would rather come live under the loving relationship and rule of the King of Kings. And today, if you don't know Jesus, there's going to be an opportunity throughout this entire meeting for you to be personally introduced to Him. We're not about religion. We're about an experience where God Himself comes and reveals His love to you, His goodness to you in the face of Jesus Christ, in the very presence of Jesus. So Holy Spirit, we ask You to take full control, for You alone can reveal Jesus. No man can reveal Jesus. Father, we pray that only Jesus will be seen, that Brother Yun will not be seen. Father, we pray that there be no earthly man, but only a heavenly man. Hallelujah. Father, we pray in Jesus' name that You strengthen the arms of our dear brother, that he may stir the coals of fire of revival. Stir the coals of revival, that the fire of revival burn again in this nation, among the hearts of Your people. Hallelujah.
Amen. And we greet you all in the name of Jesus. And I don't know why we ended up here again. There must be some mistake at the coordination office. But it's such a joy to be back here. And somehow I got the feeling as I was sitting, it was like the first generation of missionaries. And they've been doing their ministry all throughout the Roman Empire. Then they came back home and they reported what God has been doing in the last few months. We would not share anything that is happening a year ago because it's we have forgotten it already. We are just living in presence. And let me share something what's going on right now. As you remember, the little device, the clock for North Korea is working extremely well. And those of you who haven't heard about that, we created in the same cellar by the same guy who is still eating those Mexican chips. He created this for us. It's a digital clock. It works 5 years nonstop. But if you know the code, how to open these three buttons on the side, the North Korean Bible comes forth, and you can read the Bible no matter where you are. It has enough light in it so that even by night you can read the Word of God. And I come with good news. Thousands and thousands of people are walking even on the streets in North Korea, and they are only checking what is the time. The second thing, I just wanted to share something very personal. A few months ago, I again visited Iran. And Eugene did not mention, but the Chinese troops are already settled and doing good inside Iran. So we don't need to pray, God open the door. All the doors are open. And we can take in as many as we want into Iran to come and walk alongside the church in Iran. Now, I went to Tehran, and I had this idea to visit the largest mosque in Tehran at the prayer hour. So together with tens of thousands of men, I walked into the mosque. And I had only one mission. I wanted to make sure I understand how much firepower does the enemy have in Islam. So I walked into the holy of the holiest of the mosque. And when I came there, I was surprised that actually when there was no TV cameras around, there were very little prayer going on inside the mosque. It was only actually 1 out of 100 men at least trying to pretend that they are doing some kind of prayer. And I did not see any heavy attack prayers going on at all. So it looks like a lame duck to me. Rest of the men, they were sitting on the floor and playing with their iPhones and Samsungs and taking selfies. And you should have been there when the gospel cloud walked into the room. In my pocket. There's absolutely nothing impossible for God. Today, we can get in the gospel to any place, including even the headquarters of the Islamic Revolutionary Guard in Iran. There's no problem to get the gospel in. The only problem may be if you get out, but the gospel will go in. Praise God. So this is just as a report. You guys have invested in this even during the last tour and many other tours. This is what has been birthed because of that. And with great confidence, we are now increasing the numbers that we produce in China for this purpose. They are going to go hand in hand with flesh and bones of Chinese missionaries who will walk in from country after country, and they will establish a new presence of the kingdom of God. And literally, the Hebrews chapter 12 is repeated. We are surrounded by this cloud of witnesses. Literally. Praise God. Amen. Now let's move on. There is a fresh report from another country, Syria. The Chinese missionaries have been on the ground already 5 years. And they have not departed, when everybody else took off. They've been faithfully serving the Lord and serving your people in one part of Syria. They are surrounded with the both parties of the conflict. And when we met them a few weeks ago, 3 weeks ago in Cairo, we had a missionary gathering. The missionaries came from 8 countries in Middle East together just to be recharged and sent back to their field. So this is what they shared. We said, how are you able to exist and what are you able to do in Syria? And they say, we have wide open doors because the both parties, they need us. They are coming to us for help. So in the morning, the president, people who are connected with the president of Syria, that part, they will come. And in the afternoon, all the rebels, they will come. And the Chinese are in middle, and they are giving out food and support to all those who are suffering. This is a miracle of God that they have not been kicked out from Syria. Praise God. And this is what you have been involved in together with us. And not only there, a few months ago, a team of Chinese intercessors, they decided to travel by car from Beijing to Jerusalem to go along the ancient Silk Roads. And somewhere halfway on the backside of Himalayas, they came to the border of Afghanistan. And of course they were stopped. A convoy with 12 Chinese cars with Chinese plates, they arrived to the border station. And that is the eastern, northeastern part of Afghanistan is totally controlled, even today, by Taliban. And there was a Taliban captain who was leading the security forces at the border. He walked to this group of people, and he had his AK-47 pointing on their forehead. And he said, do you come from Japan? I don't know why that was relevant, but that's exactly what he asked. When the brothers and sisters from China said, no, we come from China, he put aside his weapon and he said, come over here, I want to hug you. Taliban welcome every Chinese to come to Afghanistan. From your previous information, what kind of welcome do you think you had received in that situation? Yeah, I think there's only one conclusion to that. Door is wide open. And by the way, the next country that we are now strategizing, and we need a lot of God's mercy and protection, but we have decided in the coming months to attack Saudi Arabia with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. And let me reveal, this is one of those, if I tell you, I have to kill you stories. But just that you can pray intellectually. Anytime you hit the Back to Jerusalem website, you go and pray, Lord, have mercy upon those crazy Chinese. And have mercy upon those leaders who do not give up. They just keep in deeper and deeper in the house of Muhammad. This is what we are planning. The ultimate solution is, of course, the gospel cloud. That's a very good place, thing to bring in to Saudi Arabia, where it's totally forbidden to even read the Bible or have a Bible. And it's a country where every Christian church that in the past had been existing have been destroyed. There are no churches for Arabians in Saudi Arabia, not even one. This is what we are praying now. Lord, we are going to need carriers who have a Muslim background and so fresh that they still carry the papers from the mosque, from the imam, that they are Muslims. Of course, what we don't tell to the people when they go, that they are actually already followers of Isa. Now, I have to tell you something here, which is very important. There are many people, thousands and tens of thousands of people who have left Islam and they have joined Isa. But they don't even know that they are Christians. Because Christian for them means a Westerner who is a follower of Jesus. And they have become followers of Isa. And this is what God is doing through dreams and visions. He appears to people throughout that region. And every night, tens of people in countries like Iran, they have a dream and Jesus come to them. I just met five of them a few days ago. They said, just before the tour here, they said, I was solid in bed sleeping and suddenly Isa appeared and said, take my hand and follow me and I will lead you to eternal life. That was the message. And now they were already embracing the gospel of Jesus Christ. So to get them into there, this is the plan. They will come because when you are heading Mecca and Medina, just a few miles, a few tens of miles before these holy places, there is a control post. And only certified Muslims are able to go across that point. Nobody else is able to do it. So we will load these carriers of gospel loud and they will go to that place and then they start to walk inside the city of Mecca and Medina. And the gospel will be there, present everywhere. And new people, if they capture the first batch, the next group will come in. And one day the gospel will be everywhere and it will speak to people and their lives are transformed. Praise God. Hallelujah. So it's a great opportunity to come with good news. Pray for North Korea, a continuous revival and protection upon that rising church where thousands of people embrace the gospel of Jesus Christ through the work of the missionaries. Pray for Iran that we may succeed in our 1 million Bible projects. You remember last time I showed you the micro SD cards that we are now, for God's glory, we are actually producing inside Iran. So we have now in place what we call digital bread bakeries inside Iran. And first time since revolution, the word of God is produced inside Iran for anyone who believes it. And these bakeries are very sufficient. We can spit out 100,000 Bibles a month inside Iran. Yeah. In a container like this, I have 200 of those Bibles. So it's very confident size to produce and easy to transform, transport. So thank you very much for praying for Iran and this latest enterprise in northern Iraq. For first time in the history of mankind, a people group with 800,000 people, the Yazidis people, are now first time in their lives embracing the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is an unheard opportunity to get the gospel to those who are unreached. And we're going to tick-tock one after another these unreached people groups so that we can hasten and speed up the second coming of Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you all.
Tyso, we just want to honor you for your passion. I mean, I believe it was a number of years ago that you actually went and helped Brother Yun get out of prison, right? And then you just been just keep pushing it. He just keeps pushing it. Hey, you know what? I don't want to sit around and die old and tired and worn out and sick. Wouldn't it be much better to just run wide open on the mission field with new God ideas about how to reach the unreached people groups? Hey, and who would have ever thought that we would hold up the arms of the Chinese people to go with the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, to do the things that T.L. Osborne and other people talked about so many years ago, saying, who's going to go to the stands with us? Who's going to go to the 1040 window? Who's going to go to the people who've never heard the gospel? And yet God has opened up the door for China to be able to do it. Though more than 200 million or so Chinese Holy Ghost people that have been transformed by the power of the gospel. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that just amazing? Lord Jesus, he does it. He does it in ways that no one could have ever predicted. I know you want to hear Brother Yun. I'm going to get out of the way before we have Brother Yun come. I want to give you an opportunity to share and communicate the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ to all of these nations through your giving. I know that all of you want to get on a plane and go with us right now to northern Iraq, but you just can't. Eh? You're welcome to come, right? You want to go to Mosul, but it just isn't right on the schedule for you to go to Mosul right now. But you can go with us. 100%, every penny of the offering that we receive today will go to evangelizing these regions of the Middle East that Brother Tysto just discussed. And we just hopefully that you're stirred in your heart by the Lord Jesus Christ to be a part of that. I really want some time for Brother Yun to be able to come and do a Brother Yun meeting. And I told everybody, Abiding Place is the perfect opportunity for Brother Yun to come and do a truly Brother Yun meeting. Because after we prayed about five times and had about six messages and 7 hours had passed by, the anointing starts going through the roof. You know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. And he's like, if I go anywhere with Brother Yun, he's up at 5 o'clock in the morning. He's going, where's Pastor Mark? Where's he? Because I'm supposed to be up. I'm like, I don't get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. All I'm going to do is sleep anyways. But let me start around 7 or 8, and I'm with you till late, okay? But we're going to see that happen sometime. Brother Yun's going to come, and we're going to have a 5, 6, 7 hour good old Holy Ghost, heavenly man, Chinese type of getting after the things of the Spirit, praying for each other, crying out to God for the nations. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Shamanju. Everybody, I want you to be able to stand with me for just a moment. I want you to, if you need a envelope to give by, an envelope, because you're going to give by credit card or whatever else, just raise your hand, because guys are walking around with those envelopes right now. And I want you to ask the Lord what he'd have you to do. We don't want you to give by because you have to, this is, or by constraint. We want it to be willing. We want it to be something that's in your heart to do. We want you to be stirred by the Holy Spirit to participate in what we're doing with Back to Jerusalem in the Middle East and other nations of the earth, but especially right now, Middle East. I mean, everybody's hearing about the Middle East every day on the television and on the radio. And there's more going on than what you're hearing by your spin doctors here in the United States of America. There is a divine plan being orchestrated by our Heavenly Father, by the divine purposes and will of the Lord Jesus Christ as His church moves forward in participating with Him in taking this gospel of the kingdom, the one that Jesus preached just like He preached it, to every nation as a witness to every nation. Hallelujah. The end isn't, we're not abdicating. It's not the end till it's the end. I see a great revival. Father's purposed us to live in a great revival. He's coming for a glorious church, and I figure we need to get on the move to participate with that. So, I mean, I pray in the name of Jesus that before you leave here, you won't just be stirred up about what God's doing through China, but you'll get so stirred up and say, wait a minute, I'm not going to be left behind in this race. We might have lost pace, but we're going to catch up. Okay? Come on, people. I pray you'll get some passion. Listen to me. Because with passion and faithfulness, God will do a lot through you. Somebody said, you must get so excited. Yeah, I got rivers of inspiration coming out of me right now. I'm being jolted by the power of the Holy Ghost. You try that sometime and speak quietly, and then I'll have a new example of what I'm supposed to do. But, I probably wouldn't follow you. But at any rate, I want you to go ahead now. I want you to listen to the Holy Ghost. Father, we ask you to raise up laborers for the harvest. Father, we ask you to raise us up. Father, we surrender our heart to you. Our will to you will go do whatever you want us to do, wherever you want us to do it. And Father, right now we thank you for utilizing that which you've given us by way of resources so it can go on ahead of us. In Jesus' name, I pray that not one single person will withhold their heart from you and that their treasure will have a witness in their hand. That their treasure's in you, Lord Jesus, and they're not holding anything back as we worship you, Lord. And giving Thank you, Father, for the privilege. Amen. So everybody just come. We do it like this. Everybody comes forward and throws it in the offering basket. That's the way they did it in Jesus' ministry, because he stood by watching what everybody threw in. And somebody said, how do you know that? The widow with two mites. That's how I know. Jesus stood over against the offering basket. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, I thank you for your blessing on the giver. Father, I thank you for the multiplication upon the gift. Father, I thank you that every single person will come to engage in a realm of miracle faith, and they can see that miracle go to work as you multiply those things that they sow. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that there will not be in the church anybody that holds anything back from you ever again. But with everything that we have, spirit, soul, and body, financially, materially, everything we got, we're serving you with it. From this day throughout every day on into eternity. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. 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 Everybody say, God is good. And his mercies endure forever. Say, God is good to me. And his mercies endure forever for me. Brother Yun. Brother Yun. Samedju. Samedju. Hallelujah.
Samedju. Hallelujah. Oh, Samedju. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, 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 oh. 赞美主, hallelujah. Oh, 赞美主, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. 对你身边说, 赞美主, 赞美主,
say this to one another. 赞美主, 赞美主,
赞美主, 哈利路亚, 赞美主, 哈利路亚, 不要怕, 伸出你信心的手, 大胆地对你身边人说, 赞美主,
don't be afraid, just say, speak it out fluently in Chinese, 赞美主,
赞美主, 赞美主, 赞美主, 哈利路亚,
hallelujah.
我还教弟兄这么一句话叫不要怕。
I'm going to continue my Chinese studies with you. So I'm going to teach you this. 不要怕, 不要怕, don't be afraid. 不要怕,
不要怕,
不要怕, 怕,
don't be afraid. Yeah.
Man.
不要怕, 不要怕,
不要怕,
对你身边拉起来说, 不要怕,
and now repeat this to the person next to you.
不要怕, 不要怕, 阿们, 不要怕, 耶稣爱你,
不要怕, 耶稣爱你,
不要怕, 耶稣爱你,
don't be afraid, Jesus loves you.
1, 2, 3,
不要怕, 耶稣爱你,
好吧,你对你身边至少三个人说, 不要怕, 耶稣爱你,
and now practice this with three people around you, okay? 不要怕, 耶稣爱你,
哦, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
好, 我们坐下来, 平安,
please be seated in peace, like we say in China,
hallelujah. 哇，在我给大家分享信息之前，我要介绍我一个属灵的儿子，叫所罗门。很多年呢，我给他起了名字，他现在是传道人，还有他的女朋友来了，站起来让大家认识一下。
I want to introduce a good friend of mine. He came to the Lord. He visited me in Germany. He came to the Lord, and his name is Brother Solomon. He's here with his girlfriend, and the brother is already serving the Lord. I just want to introduce this brother to you.
我们欢迎他，哈利路亚。
Let's welcome them to the meeting.
坐下来，不要怕，耶稣爱你。
Don't be afraid. Jesus loves you.
我希望这句话你要记下来，放在你的心里。你看见黄皮肤人的时候，
And I really want that you capture this into your heart. Next time you see a yellow skin who looks very Chinese to you, a person, you just speak it out with passion and love.
你就非常热情的，你不要怕说的不标准，只要你很真诚热情。And
with great passion, don't be think I cannot really pronounce it correctly. With great passion, you just speak it out what I have teach you.
他会因为你的一句话，他会成为基督徒，可能这个人会成为一个改变，一个家族民族的人。
And it may happen that that person, you speak out these words, his life is totally transformed, and he takes hold of Jesus, and Jesus will make him to be one of these Chinese God is going to use to shake up our generation.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
多少人和我一样相信这本新旧约圣经是神的话，可以改变人的命运。
So how many of you believe like myself that Bible is the living word of God? It will change our nation and it will change our destiny.
我们一同站起来读一段圣经，大家都会背的，《约翰福音》第14章12节，大家一起来背就好了。
Let us stand up and read one Bible verse together. So open your Bibles from Gospel of John. And chapter 14, and let us repeat together in one voice, verse 12, like we do in China. So as soon as you have found this, these are the words of Jesus.
耶稣说，我实实在在的告诉你们，我所做的事，信我的人也要做，并且要做比这更大的事。
And let's start now. 1, 2, 3. Very truly, I tell you, whoever believes in me will do the works I've been doing, and they will do even greater things than these, because I am going to the Father.
Hallelujah. 对于前面，上帝要叫你做更大的事。
Now say to one another, God wants you to do greater things.
神要把一个突破性的恩膏给你，你要做更大的事。
And God wants to give you a booster into your life. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
好，我们坐下来。
Okay, please be seated in peace again.
我每一次来到美国的时候，我第一个一定会想到我的好朋友马可这个家族。
Every time I land to United States of America, the first person I think about from America is my dear friend Pastor Mark and his family.
神那个国度里面就需要像这样有为神国度癫狂的人。
And because I believe that every nation needs to have people who are torch carriers of the gospel of Jesus Christ in that nation, who are passionate about what they are doing.
我们一起在美国从南到北，从东到西，大小小很多。每一次开始在大家敬拜神的时候，我就想到他的儿子，他真正是个敬拜的人，全然投入。
Every time we, like on this tour, we have covered the west to east, east to west, and north to south of this country. And every meeting, when the worship have started, I have missed the son and the children of Mark as passionate as they are when they are leading the worship at the church.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. 一个人遇见神了以后，神给他说的话语，那是一辈子就不没有办法忘记的。
Whenever there's a human being who have a supernatural encounter, meeting with Jesus, and Jesus speaks something into their heart, that person will never lose that. It will be with him the rest of his life. I have shared so many times my personal testimony in this church.
可是我现在是要来讲，自我17岁遇见耶稣以后，后来多次被关进监牢里。
But today I'm going to talk a little bit what happened in my life, what were the consequences after I met Jesus and he called me to ministry, how I was captured and thrown to prison many times.
一生中让我最难以忘记的就是我在监牢里面，在人生最绝望、没有路走的时候，耶稣出现在我生命之中那一句话。
Actually, the biggest treasure of my life are those situations when I have been totally downcasted and I didn't see any solution, any future for myself. And in that lowest point of my life, again and again, Jesus came and appeared to me and spoke to me.
因为我说神啊，你呼召我是起来向西向南传福音，你没有呼召我做监，那我不能够传福音，我就愿意不能够传道，就愿意寻道。
I was very clear with Jesus. I said, Jesus, I reminded him, you called me to be your witness, to preach the gospel in west and south, but you didn't mention anything that you will allow them to throw me to prison. If this is my future, I rather die for salvation of my nation in the prison than continue to be in the prison.
我再容许我再问一下，有多少人看过《天上人》这一本书？
Now let us do a check. How many of you have read the Heavenly Man book?
大部分。
Most of you have read my story.
可能让你最难以接受的就是说，其实一个人74天不吃饭，怎么能够活着？是真的吗？
In my story, the passage that is most unbelievable for any believer is when we were sharing that for 74 days I was without food and liquid in the prison.
是真的，一开始。
But that is the truth.
关进到监牢里面，我知道我很需要耶稣，我必须要效法耶稣，禁食祷告。
That time it started with because the treatment was so bad and I was so much suffering so much. So I got this idea. I have to be like Jesus. I have to face my challenges like Jesus. So I decided I'm going to fast and pray.
我说主啊，你知道我是软弱的。
And I said, Lord, you know I'm so weak. I have no strength in me anymore.
我禁食祷告到38天那一天，那是每一天那个度过都是我已经进存祷告中度过38天那一天，是我人生最痛苦的时候。
I have been fasting and praying 38 days. The 38th night became a really spiritual battle for me.
突然之间有一个人冒充耶稣，他穿了一身白，走到我的身边说。 仆人不能大于主人，学生不能高过先生。And
that 39th night, a white-clothed person walked into my cell, and he looked like Jesus. And this is what he said, a servant cannot do greater things than his master. A student cannot become wiser than his teacher.
耶稣禁食40昼夜。 难道你要大过耶稣吗？
He said to me, because he wasn't Jesus, he said to me, Jesus fasted 40 days and nights. You cannot pass that day.
我现在告诉你，魔鬼来的声音总是带给你的是你心中那种惊恐不安。And
I tell you, even when Satan appears in the shape of Jesus, his words create tremendous fear and pain inside you. And you know it is not Jesus speaking to you.
那个时候，因为放到监牢里的时候，就是要叫我做犹大，要么就放弃你的信仰。They had really treated
me very bad. They wanted me to quit my beliefs in Jesus, and they did everything to torture me to become a Judas.
我每一天都闭上眼睛，我不需要看，我也不说话。我说主啊，你说话。
Every day when they brought me to the torture, I closed my eyes. I didn't want to look at those who are torturing me. I kept my mouth shut. I didn't say one word to them.
那一天的征战是。 我人生中最激烈的几个人把我拉出去了以后，就用那个六号针头往那个手里面来扎。你不说话，我们会帮助你说话。And
one day they were really decided that they're going to get me to speak, and they dragged me from my solitary cell to the torture room, and they start to squeeze acid under my nails one after other, and that was the most horrible pain I ever experienced in my life.
我从昏迷中醒过来的时候，我发出一种声音对神：“爸爸，我要回家。”
A long time after, when I returned back to my conscience, I said, "Father, Abba, Father, allow me to come back home today. I don't want to remain in this situation.
My
pain was horrible. I cannot be greater than Jesus. And what is going to happen during that
39th day?
I had already decided I'm going to die for Jesus rather than to be somebody who will sell, betray Jesus. And even though during those years nobody were publicly beheaded like what the ISIS is doing today, but many of my brothers and sisters, they were beating and so heavily that they died in the prison.
就在那个突然之间，我完全绝望的时候，我听到主告诉了孩子，我知道。
But when I was at that lowest point of my life, suddenly I heard Jesus saying to me, "My child, I know everything you are going through right now."
如果你看我的故事，你一定会看到这一段话语，因为神当时告诉我说：“看呐，我要给你一个敞开的门。”那个一幅图画出现了，
the Lord said to me,
那个门就越来越大的开了。
See, I'm going to open the doors for you. Nobody is able to keep shut. And I saw how the prison doors, one after other, were open for me to walk out from the prison.
有一句话语进入到我的生命，就是说，
and one word came to my heart.
我实实在在地告诉你，我所做的事，相信我的人也能做，并且要做比这更大的事。这个话语好像一种极大的能力。
This word came to me that moment. Very truly, I tell you, whoever believes in me, he will do the works I have been doing, and they will do even greater things than these, because I am going to my Father.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
你不需要配过去的条条框框说限制，你相信耶稣，他做的事，你要做，要做更大的事。
From the past to hinder you to grow in your faith and trust upon Jesus about your future.
马可，我的祷告是要为大家祷告，要上帝要给我们一个更大、更突破性的一个恩膏。
And I'm really, my prayer today is that everybody of you would have this booster anointing, turbo anointing upon your lives.
你开始去想那些你从来没有想过的事，要做那些从来没有做过的事，
and in order for you to receive it, you have to think about, dream about, imagine about unbelievable things that you cannot achieve yourself. You have to aim high.
Hallelujah.
We have to go.
Jesus said, all heaven,
all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, you should go.
魔鬼没有任何权柄，
Satan have no authority.
奉耶稣的名求什么，你就会有一个突破。
In order for you to be victorious, you have to be turbocharged.
我告诉各位， I tell you, 我在那里遇见耶稣， 他告诉我要做更大的事， 那一刹那我完全明白， 我可以不吃饭， 可以不喝水， 我可以活着，
you know that moment after I've been fasting and praying for 39 days, I understood I can do greater than Jesus. So I continued. I said, Lord, if this is what you want me to do, I don't eat, I don't drink, and you will sustain me until the day you will take me to heaven. And one day became 2 days and 3 days, and I did not eat, I didn't drink.
他们看没有办法了，只得通知我的妈妈、姐姐、妹妹一起到监牢里来看我，要么就送火葬场了。And
they keep going over 70 days, and then finally they came to conclusion that any moment I'm going to die. So they reported to my home and called my mother and my wife and my older sister to come and collect me and bury me. And when they came to the visitation room, I was lying on the floor unconscious. They did not recognize my body anymore.
妈妈从我的后面找到,
it was only after long examination, my mother found a birthmark on my back and another one on my face, and she cried out, "This is truly my son."
我是在昏迷中, 在受折磨昏迷之中拉出去的, 当我醒来的时候, 我睁开眼睛看见是在妈妈怀里。
And I was so amazed because I was unconscious when they dragged me from my solitary cell to the visitation room. And when I came to my conscience, I was at the lap of my mother. I was so amazed that mother is here.
我第一个请求了妈妈, 算我不孝准, 儿子决定要为主寻道。
And the first words I said to my mother, "Mother, I am not going to betray Jesus. I have decided I'm willing to die for Jesus." And then I took hold of my wife and I said, "My dear wife, the Lord is going to take me to heaven today. But one day we are going to meet again in the kingdom of God."
姐姐很生气，打了耳光。你不要妈妈，你也不要你的妻子，还有你妻子都是孩子。My
older sister was not that spiritual. She hit me on my ear. "You stupid man! You don't want your wife. You don't want your children. You don't want your mother."
但打没有用处的，我感受到。
Help anything.
神就在这个时候，我。 我感觉到我的妈妈真正是个先知，是个祷告的人。
At that moment, I experienced something special. I understood suddenly that my mother was a prophet of God because this is what she said to me.
妈妈就开始，儿子，耶稣告诉我让你活住，你活住是为了耶稣啊，儿子。
And she said to me, "My son, this is what Jesus wants to say to you. He wants you to live your life for His glory."
当我的妈妈开始来说，你活着不是为妈妈，也不是为主妻子，你活着是为了耶稣。你听妈妈说，
And that really spoke to me. She said, "You don't live your life for your wife or your sister or your mother. Live your life for Jesus and His glory."
当我的妈妈讲，给我来讲话，能够对话的时候呢，经常认为我会说话了，就抓住他，这家伙他装的他会说话。
The guards who were monitoring the activities in the visit, they recognized that I was able to speak. So brutally, they separated me and they started to drag me back to my solitary cell.
那个天门拉开那一刹那，妈妈还在外面喊着：“儿子，活住啊，活住是为了耶稣啊！”
And the last words I heard as they were dragging me deeper inside the prison was my mother who was shouting, "My son, live your life fully for His glory." And this was the voice that remained for a long time in my heart.
我用母亲的话语来鼓励你，大胆地对你身边说，不要怕，活着为了耶稣。
And I really want to encourage you to repeat this to the person next to you aloud. Don't be afraid. Live your life for His glory.
活着为了耶稣。
Live your life for Jesus.
后来我开始在受审，开始了。
And then they continue to torture me.
这些神巡的人就是说，啊，原来你是会说话的呀，你是会吃饭会。And those policemen
who were torturing me, "Okay, now we know that you are not mute, you are able to speak."
你现在老实交代你的问题，你真的能够活住，还能够活住回去。And
then they said, "If you just answer to our questions, we are going to release you and you can return back home alive."
我当时，神就放在我的里面的一些话语。The
Lord has deposited something into some of His words in my heart.
信仰对我来讲，
And I started to think that my faith and my trust and my belief in Jesus has become already a cancer, the terminal cancer in my body, and I cannot get rid of it.
我你可以这样,
and as they were beating me up and they were saying that they're going to kill me, and it doesn't matter, I'm dying anyway.
他说会判你多少年, 甚至到死刑, 我说,
and they said, we're going to sentence you for execution or lifetime in prison. And it doesn't matter, I'm dying anyway.
我非常喜欢有人会唱一首诗歌说, 我愿意, 我愿意。
I have heard that in the West you are singing, Lord, I want to follow you everywhere you go. I was singing that two words, Lord, I'm willing to follow you. And I repeated those words, I'm willing to follow you.
我今天在这里来讲我的故事给大家，我是渴望，我心中最深的渴望，信仰是需要每一个人个人来跟神有一个相遇。And
the reason why I'm sharing about this is to really emphasize that our faith has to become our personal relationship with Jesus Christ.
如果你个人经历到耶稣的时候，让你死，让你活，判无期，没有问题呀。我们在监牢里一群人跟他争着，有一群人呢，我们判刑的时候，枪毙了好几个。这个因为祷告的时候，有人主接他走了，到最后人家要把责任推的时候，都说是我，那个说我，那每个人都说是自己，只有是把几个都枪毙了。I
remember in one situation where there was somebody had died in the cell. They started to accuse all us others, and they put the blame because the person died because of the torture and have nothing to do with us. And then finally they decided that the closest people who have been sharing the same cell, they are all guilty. So they executed all those brothers for something they were innocent.
不过我的人生不是24个小时都属灵的。
Now, as I'm sharing this, I'm not saying that I'm a 24/7 super believer of Jesus. I have lost my trust and hope on Him many times in my life. I was like Abraham. I always said, Lord, you gave me the calling of my life to go and preach the gospel to west and south, all the way back to Jerusalem. So after being over 10 years in different times in prison for the sake of the gospel and this
我告诉你, 第三次关在监牢, 我真正等不及了。
And I tell you the truth, that third time, 1997, when they captured me, that was an unbelievable, impossible time of my life.
Especially
after they crushed my both legs with the sledgehammers, and they said, you're never going to stand up, you're never going to walk, you're never going to preach the gospel.
I started to believe.
And suddenly,
很久没有见日头,
I experienced that there is no presence of the word of God. There was just a complex darkness all over me, and I was out of breath.
耶和华呀, 我的心仰望你,
Lord my God,
耶和华,
my God is expecting.
求你将你的道指示我,
Let
将你的路教训我,
to surround
将你的路教训我,
me.
求你以你自己的名字来引导我。
I said, Lord, for your own name's sake, surround me with your presence.
因为你是救我的神, You
are my God. I am expecting for you.
那时候在那个监牢里面，好像天天都在等候。
I was just waiting. I could not see any new day for my life.
甚至我大声喊道，好像守夜里等候天亮。
I said, I'm like a watchman waiting all the hours of the night for a new day to dawn.
神啊，我仰望你的话，你给我说一句话也可以。
I said, Lord, speak even one word to my misery, enlighten my life.
弟兄姊妹，有时候神不对我们说话，并不等于神不知道，也并不等于神不爱我们。Now
I have to tell you that there are moments in our life when He is completely silent, but it's not an evidence that He does not love us, that He doesn't care for us.
我的生命中有很多想不通的东西，有很多为什么。
I have so many disagreements with Jesus about His way He has been treating me.
神啊，你呼召我传福音，你没有呼召这样做艰难。
Lord, you told me to preach the gospel and be faithful with that. You never even mentioned that I was just looking for trouble for my life and imprisonment.
感谢神。
Praise the Lord.
亚伯拉罕因着信在无可指望的时候，他仍然还是因着信，他成为万国之父。
And like Abraham, despite what is possible in the human realm, he kept his trust upon the Lord, and he experienced a greatest miracle. He got the son.
现在不管你面临着什么样的压力环境，
I don't know what pressure and troubles are going on in your life.
你还是要相信耶稣，他都知道。
Put your trust upon Jesus and upon the fact He knows everything you are going through right now.
纵然你对神失去信心，我告诉你，神仍是可信的。
It may happen that you are unfaithful, but He remains faithful because He cannot deny Himself.
他没有对你失去信心。
He haven't lost trust on you. He still trusts you as His child.
我那个时候喊叫的时候，警察围那看守人员围绕到那个监号的时候，这家伙疯了，没有用。As
I was crying all this in this darkness to the Lord, I was so much in pain in my spirit that even the warden of the prison, they all rushed to the outside my cell door, and they said, "Oh, this preacher have lost his mind."
我真的很喜欢使徒保罗说，我们如同那个，他如同宝器宝贝放在我这个瓦器里，那个时候瓦器真的碎了。
And there's one picture in the Bible that always comforts me. It's when Paul said that we have this treasure in a jar of clay. Now my whole clay jar was a mess on the floor, but the treasure was still there.
我才知道，那个宝贝会，那个瓦器会压碎，那个宝贝压不碎啊。到当你完全压碎的时候，那个能力会出来了。
The jar may leak water and life, but the treasure is complex, is valid and tight.
我遇见主那个时候，主告诉我一件事情，说，你的天已经亮了。
And in that situation, by His mercy, Jesus walked into my solitary cell. And He said to me, "Now is the new day dawning for you. Doors have been opened for you."
我心中挣扎，这个挣扎我讲过很多次。我在想，这是监狱啊，明明是监牢，四道监狱。
I have shared this many times at this church. My reflection to that was, Jesus, this is a top security prison. You don't walk out alive from these places like this.
我现在是讲给你的，也是主给我所讲的话语。
I give you the reply.
那是事实，但我是真理。Jesus
said, "I know where you are. Your prison is real, but I am the truth, and the truth will set you free."
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
我仍然是告诉你的问题是事实，但真理能给你自由。So say to you today,
your problems are real, but Jesus is the truth, and the truth is able to set you free.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
走出监牢，再一次听到主告诉我的话语，说，那就是13年前发生的事。主说，我是圣洁，真实的。And
the Lord repeated the same words I have heard 13 years earlier in the prison, and He said to me, "I am the Holy One, and the truly one. I have the keys of David in my hand. The doors I open, no man is able to keep shut.
And
I saw how suddenly, not only that the security prison doors were opened for me, but the doors to the Buddhist world, Hindu world, and Islamic world were totally open for the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The
opportunity, the momentum is crucial. If Lord say the door is open, it requires you to take action and not start to pray about it. Think about my situation. A few months later, I have come out and I was number one wanted criminal. Then the Lord enforced this desire. It's time for me to leave from China. I have never had an ID card. I have never had a resident permit. I have a criminal, heavy criminal record. And I was a wanted criminal without passport or any documentation. And still, by His mercy and grace, He took me out from China. And I'm still totally innocent about the language. I don't know even how many alphabets you have in English or German or any Western language.
But I met the Lord when I was 60 years old.
But I have served the Lord for 41 years today. And I can just tell you with great confidence, Jesus is real.
Hallelujah. So,
already many years, the Lord been speaking to me to go to Middle East, go to Middle East, go to Middle East. When I started to go to Middle East, and I have a personal experience that these what you call the closed nations for the gospel from the West, in every one of those nations, the doors are wide open for yellow-skinned Chinese to go in and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ.
I
never forgot my first visit to Egypt. I got a special permit from the president of Egypt to get into country because I still don't have a passport. So when I went there and I discovered that there are new believers among the Chinese community who have not been baptized, so I traveled together with them to the Red Sea and I started to baptize these Chinese. And as we were there, God's Spirit started to move among the Egyptians who were there at the same locations. And more than 100 Egyptians also wanted to be baptized together with Chinese in the Red Sea.
They
saw that there's a yellow-skinned guy with the white dress in the water, and he's baptizing the people. And they all said, "We are believers. We want to be baptized."
那第二个总统下台那一天，就是下台那一天，因为我感受到那。
Second time, there was another turmoil going on, and the second president was kicked out from the office, and I was able to go back to Egypt. And I felt that I have to go and encourage the Back to Jerusalem missionaries who are now stationed and operating in Egypt.
Because we went there, I started to go to a cafe, and there were some people. 当地人啊，弟兄姊妹来了，请大家喝个咖啡，到那儿来吃饭的时候，我就拉着大家开始跪那祷告。华人当时还有点非常怕，说：“啊，愿弟兄不敢。”我说：“来呀，跪下来。”我就开始跪下来，拉着大家。
And one day I went to a coffee shop, and the owner of the coffee shop was a Chinese businessman, and there were some Chinese working there, and there were a lot of other people. So I just collected all those believers together and say, let us all kneel down in the middle of the coffee shop and let us start to pray and call upon the name of Jesus upon Egypt.
Hallelujah. 等我们开始祷告起来的时候，拉着大家，这个酒店的老板，他们几个跑了，我们的国家真的很需要你们这个信仰。
And then I was wrong. He said the owner was an Egyptian man. And he came to me afterwards and he said, our country does not need anything more than that. People who are praying for our country, and that will change our nation.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我告诉你，神要在中东地区要开始做一些事情，是远超过人所想的。
And I tell you and I prophesied what God is about to do in Middle East and Central Asia is beyond your imagination. Hallelujah.
我来到这里之前，我是在到埃及，给那些同工们从苏丹的、从叙利亚的、从埃及、从伊朗的，我过来。
I was, as I mentioned earlier, we were meeting with Chinese missionaries in Egypt. They came from Sudan, Syria, Lebanon, and surrounding countries, and we all were together sharing the mighty works of the Lord.
我就是要听听他们怎样在叙利亚在那个战火中生活的。
And I was especially asking the missionaries from Syria, how can you survive and exist in the middle of all this killing and war?
我说这两三年没有你们的消息，你们怎么生活？And
I said for 3 years we haven't even heard anything, any sound. We don't even know if you are still alive.
他说我们不怕呀，华人在那儿。我告诉你啊，现在我们的大使馆撤了，领事馆也没有了。可是我们华人在到那个地方的那些恐怖分子也喜欢我们，这些当地的人受欺负的也喜欢我们。
The Chinese consulate, the embassy had been closed many years ago. The consulate has been closed many years ago. But the terrorists and the rebels, they just love us and they want our help. And so does the government forces. They love us and they protect us.
打死了，留下这里一个家庭八九十来个孩子，没有办法，我们就给他们送点菜呀，我们向施主给他们讲这个阿拉伯话。
And the Chinese missionaries they shared, there are so many families where father has been killed in the battlefield. So they had a mother with 8 children, up to 12 children, and we have just providing help to these families one after other.
他们说你们不要跟我们讲阿拉伯话，我们想跟你们学中文呐，我们不想学阿拉伯。
They were so special, these Syrian families. They said, "Don't try to speak Arabic to us. We want to learn Chinese. Speak to us Chinese."
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
当他们这样来做的时候，最奇妙的事情，他们可以带领他们祷告，真正他们一个一个的家庭开始跪下来接受耶稣。Open possibility
for interaction with the local suffering people. Family after family was praying together with them and came to a personal faith to Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
神现在在中东地区做事，我非常喜欢马可你说，我们要配搭，一起同工。
And the Lord is doing some amazing work throughout Middle East and Central Asia. And I'm so happy for Pastor Mark challenging us to join hands together for this great harvest and partnership.
你不要想到中东地区没有希望，中东地区已经有很多人听到耶稣的名字了，他们知道耶稣的爱，真的他们已经知道。
And it's not true anymore that people in Middle East and Central Asia, they know anything about Jesus because Jesus is appearing to them in dreams, and Chinese missionaries are demonstrating on the ground the love of Jesus Christ to all of them.
我们要用另外一个眼光来看这个中东地区。
So let us have
a
little another perspective to what is happening in Central Asia, Middle East.
我不是一个成功。不是一个成功的传道人，也不是一个成功的探子，但是我告诉你一件事情，那个耶利哥，那个妓女拉合住在耶利哥城，好像我们现在这个世界一样啊，看不到希望。
Let me use another picture. I'm not any superb Bible teacher, and I'm not highly educated. But there's one story in the Bible, in the Old Testament, it really captured my attention.You remember the time when Joshua sent the spies to Jericho, and they went into the house of a prostitute.
神能够透过了一个妓女拉合，给这个以色列这个百姓啊，有一些正确的报告说，这个国家需要以色列民，这个国家已经对他自己的宗教没有希望了，需要认识耶和华。
Because God was able to use that prostitute, and she actually shares many years ago already. We heard the news how your God is with us. Everybody is filled with fear, and our gods are not going to able to protect us. You are going to take over.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
这个国家很需要我们把这个世界很需要我们真正把耶稣的爱给他们福音的真实的爱。
Desperately needs us to be mirrors of the truly love and compassion of Jesus Christ.
政府他们可以去打他们的仗，但是我们教会不是打仗，我们
教会
尽管把基督的爱给他们。
But let us take the number one weapon of this universe, the weapon of love, and bring the love of Jesus to all these suffering people.
Hallelujah.
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 可能你今天说听到我说报告你的信息，就说神在中东地区这个门，不是我在监牢里看到那个印象开了，是现在真正是开了。
And what I'm sharing now is not...about the vision that the Lord saw me already 1983 when I was heavily tortured in the prison China. I'm sharing about reality. It is happening right now. The doors are open for the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah. 我非常感谢神在几年前呢、啊马克弟兄真正他非常顺服神，我就是来讲过，你可以到山东去看呐、啊。他去到山东，你当时对大家的鼓励，他们一直在往前走。
I was the one who told him to go to China and visit the church in Shandong in East China.
今天早上山东的弟兄姊妹在给我打电话，他说那个峰那个马克呀，什么时候还能够再来呀、啊？他说将来我们还是很喜欢的。
And the brothers who now have already departed from China, and they are missionaries in Pakistan, they called me early this morning. And when they heard that we are going to visit the church of Pastor Mark, I said, oh, we just love Pastor Mark, so we hope that he come to visit us.
早上又打电话，又说叫马克也来到巴基斯坦嘛，好不好？你叫他来吧。
You have to ask Pastor Mark to come and visit us as we are in Pakistan.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
真的，因为他知道我今天会在你们这里来讲道的，他们都真正是这样来讲的。
And they knew that I'm going to be here, so just get the one-way ticket for Pastor Mark and send him to Pakistan.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
也许上帝要借取你要做更大的事吗
I believe that God wants to use all of our lives for do greater things for the kingdom of God.
你现在你们这个城市就也像个耶利哥城一样
You may feel that San Diego, this city, is like the Jericho, surrounded by high walls you are not able to penetrate.
我感受到这个城市还需要有很多的教会陪建，你不要这里想到这里已经很大，还没有做满，还需要有很多的教会陪建，开始新的教会。
There are not absolutely not enough alive churches of Jesus Christ in this city. It's not enough to just have one here, but its city have to be surrounded with houses of prayer and churches, living churches of Jesus Christ.
这个国家有很多的难民需要教难民的教会, 也有很多的妓女需要在教妓女那个地方有教会。
There are so many refugees who are flooding into this nation, and they need to have a possibility to establish in their own language a living church of Jesus Christ.
可能神要用你们要在不同的医院也好，学校也好，不同的区域里面，不同的层次里面要开始建立教会。Lord
want to send you to the prisons and to the hospitals and to the schools and establish house churches, prayer places for Jesus Christ.
这是我今天给大家祷告的时候，灵修的信息说，
This is the message 上帝要借取你们要做更大的事。 The Lord want to do greater things through this local church.
你愿意吗？
Are you ready for that?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
我一直在讲，我要与神相遇，与神相遇。你愿意与神相遇吗？
The key is this. You have to have again a fresh meeting face to face with Jesus. Are you ready for that meeting? Amen. Let us all stand up together. And now our prayer is not the regular closing prayer. This is a very important prayer. If you need more Bible teaching, Pastor Mark and his co-workers are fully equipped to share the word of God. I just want to lead you into a fresh meeting with Jesus Christ, and that will change your life.
也许你今天在主日来到这里，你带了一大堆的问题，你看见了很多的问题，你心里有很大的压力，你今天就来到耶稣的面前，做一个突破性的祷告。
If you carry your burdens and problems to the church, and you are just, your eyes are fixed upon your impossibilities in your life, turn your eyes upon Jesus and have a fresh meeting with Jesus.
可能你是一个公司的员工，像那个玛利亚在那个宴席上看见人没有宴席的主人没有酒了。可能你是公司的一个员工，看见你的公司已经干不下去了。
Maybe you are your working place. It's going to go good for that business, and you see here that this is not going well. God has put you there to bring a new blessing upon your working place.
Mark, 也许你们支持这个美国的公民，看见这个奥巴马，看见这个国家真正没有路了，那你今天就把这件事情带到耶稣的面前。
And if you have been worried, what is the future, the political future going to be for this nation, and you are thinking about Obama and everything around him, bring him to Jesus today.
我们要像玛利亚一样,
Let us be like Mary, the mother of Jesus, who said to this, and whatever he tells you to do, do it to the servants.
我们这一群人认识耶稣是谁? 我们要把这个国家, 把这个国家的每一个层面的事情, 把这个教会不能不认的情况带到耶稣的面前。
We are supposed to bring all the challenges and needs of our nation and present them to the Lord of Lords and King of Kings.
可能你从前从来没有跟向耶稣求教谁变或者说他没有酒了要做什么事，今天你就大胆地对耶稣说，这个国家真的需要你。
Maybe you ever have believed that God is still able to make wine from the water at your working place or in your family.
你愿意来到耶稣的面前吗？
Are you willing to meet with Jesus? Let us all surround, come forward, and let us start to pray.
我们来到耶稣的面前， 我们跪到耶稣的面前， 对耶稣说， 主啊，
As we kneel down before the Lord, say, we confess, Lord, I am willing, I'm ready.
我真的愿意为这个国家祷告。
I want to pray for this nation.
我真的看见这个国家快没有酒了，没有钱了，没有什么了。Lord,
I recognize my nation don't have any wine anymore, any spiritual wine.
如果你来到主的面前，你会发现你的亲戚、你的朋友、你的老板、你的公司现在在危机之中，你不需要告诉别人，你就对主说主啊。And
share to Jesus the needs in your family, at your working place, among your relatives, and among your friends.
你愿意与主相遇，你都把你的心中的讲的话语。
Open your heart and start to speak, start to communicate with Jesus.
主耶稣，我们需要你的话语。
Lord Jesus, we need to have a fresh meeting with you.
只要你说一句话，我们愿意顺服你。
Lord, if you only speak out one word, we are willing to follow you.
我们愿意把我们的生命。
Lord, we will surrender our lives to serve you.
把我们的时间完全地都给你，主啊，我们等候你。
Lord, we are expecting and waiting before you.
我们跪在你的面前，主啊。
We are kneeling before you, Lord. Send your word.
这个城市里面有很多的人真的还没有听到，真的需要你。
Lord, this region needs to hear the good news of Jesus.
主啊，你差遣我这个教会的弟兄姊妹，走到妓女的人群之中，走到那种监牢里面，走到医院的里面。
Lord, transform the hearts of my brothers and sisters. Equip them to become movers and shakers for your kingdom.
医院里需要听到耶稣的声音，妓女，这些黑社会的人需要听到耶稣的声音。All
the gangsters and prostitutes and sinners of this city, they have to hear the good news of Jesus and embrace the love of Jesus.
你的亲戚朋友，你的学校老师们，他们真的很需要耶稣啊。
Your teachers, your bosses, they need to have embraced the love of Jesus.
你对主说，你的主啊，我愿意。你差遣我，我也愿意去到穆斯林地区。
Lord, I am willing to allow your spirit to lead my life.
我也愿意去到非洲，我也愿意去到中国，我也愿意去到巴基斯坦，我也愿意去到没有一个人愿意去的地方。
Lord, I am available.
你说主啊，你对着主啊，拿掉我心中的惧怕，我愿意。我愿意。 Oh, little Tisama, little Tiso, little Tisama, little Tis. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Revival fires, Lord. Your revival, your outpouring. God, your fire, Holy Spirit, wind. Oh God, America, oh Father, we pray again. Strengthen us yet one more time, oh Lord. Strengthen us yet just this one more time, oh God. Let your glory fill the land. Let your glory fill the land like in the days of old. In the former times, oh God, when you destroyed the powers of darkness, oh God, your anointing, oh God, your glory, Lord, your great outpourings, oh let the sound of prayer begin. Oh, let the sound of intercessions be heard. Oh, God, we pray, raise up in this last day those who go for you, no matter what the challenges, no matter what the hindrances, this nation belongs to you. America is yours. The United States born out of a holy move from you. Oh God, we pray in Jesus' name. Let your glory and your fame be heard among us in the midst of your church, oh God. Let your saints arise. Let your saints arise. Harvest of the Lord. Let your saints arise, oh God. Let your glory cover this land. Your glory once again. Holy Ghost and fire. Great and mighty ladder reigns, oh God, your spirit once again. Yearly and your ladder reign again, oh God, we cry in the time of rain for America. It's a desolate time of drought and famine, God, but we know the rains from you will fall again. Send the rain, send the rain, send the rain, oh God, send the rain, the early and the latter rain. Bless America with the churches on fire with your presence, with revival fires burning, with a holiness returning to you, Lord. Let your glory fill the land. Let every yoke be broken once again. Ha. Oh God, we cry to you. Do these things, oh God, that only you can do. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. I'll go. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me, oh God. Here I am, send me. Father, we pray in Jesus' name that every person will hear of your fame, that they'll see your glory high and lifted up, oh God. Father, we pray that every soul in this place will have an encounter with you, Lord, that they'll hear your voice calling out to them, saying, who will go for us? Who will go for us? Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. I'll go wherever you lead, I'll go. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever you lead, I'll go. I'll follow you. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever you lead, I'll follow. Wherever you go, I'll go. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever you lead, I'll follow. Wherever you go, I'll go. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. I surrender all to you. We surrender all to you, oh God, passionately. Oh, we surrender all to you, oh Lord. Wherever you go, we'll go. We'll follow you, Lord Jesus. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. I'm yours. Here I am, send me. Wherever Wherever you lead, we'll follow. Wherever you go, we'll go. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Take my life like bread and break me. Fill the multitudes. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Take my life like bread and break me. Fill the multitudes. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever you lead, I'll follow. Wherever you go, I'll go. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Let the glory fill the land. Lord, let your glory fill the land. Lord, let your glory fill your church. Lord, let your glory fill my life. Here I am. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever you lead, I'll follow. Wherever you go, I'll go. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever the Lamb goes, I will go. I'll only go with you. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Not my life, but your life, for that's all that I desire. Here I am, send me. Oh God, here I am, send me. Oh, not my life, but your life, Jesus. This is my desire. Lord, send me. Lord, send me.
Hallelujah. Just lift up your voice. Just lift up your voice. Just lift up your voice.
Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever you go, I'll follow. I'll only go with you. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Not my life, but your life. That's all that I desire. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever you go, I'll follow. I'll only go with you. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. With the Pentecostal fire, with the rushing mighty wind, let your glory shake this earth with revival once again. With the Pentecostal fire, with the mighty rushing wind, let your glory fill this land. Let a shaking come again. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Wherever you lead, I'll follow. Lord, I'll go with you. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Not too young and not too old, Master, here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Oh God. Quiero mamá no se derere, no lugar en la. With the Pentecostal fire, with a rushing mighty wind, let your glory fill the earth, oh God, with the shaking once again. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. With your mighty signs and wonders, breaking every yoke, breaking every yoke. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. Jesus, be glorified, be glorified in my life, Lord Jesus. Be glorified in my life. Be glorified in my life. Lord Jesus, be glorified in me. Be glorified in my life, Lord Jesus. Be glorified in me. Be glorified in my life, Lord Jesus, be glorified in me. Here I am, send me. Here I am, send me. With your Pentecostal fire, with the rushing mighty wind, let your glory fill the land, oh God, and let the shakings now begin. Come on. With a Pentecostal fire, with the rushing mighty wind, let your glory fill the earth, oh God, and let the shakings now begin. With a Pentecostal fire, with your rushing mighty wind, let your glory fill the earth again, let the shaking now begin. With a Pentecostal fire, with a rushing mighty wind, let your glory fill the earth, O Lord, let your shakings now begin. With the glory of your presence, your signs and wonders, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Paul said he preached the gospel. He preached the full gospel. That's what he said. With mighty signs and wonders and the power of the Holy Ghost in all the known world from Jerusalem to Illyricum is what he, the geographical location that he defined. So if God is going to do through you and me what is the only remedy, what has got to happen, can't be done any other way, then you and I are going to have to experience exactly what his disciples and approximately 120 people experienced on the day of Pentecost. When the Lord Jesus told them, just wait, I will empower you. I will empower you to represent me and the resurrection. Today, just ask him. You got to get rid of all of your ideology and all your philosophies and all the things you think of how it's supposed to go down and how many things aren't, you know, still happening today that happened then.
and pare it right down to God the Father's will, that which He's purposed to do in the earth, to glorify the name of His only begotten Son, Jesus, through you and me. It's only by the power of the Holy Spirit. And so right now, as you're kneeled here in this place, for everybody who's willing, for everybody who's hungry, there are people who are, you know, they just don't understand. There may be people here today, you just don't really even understand how to move forward with God. Even though the Word of God is very clear on it, you may just not even understand, how do I move forward with God? But if you're just hungry and thirsty for the things of the kingdom of God, Father will pour out the things of the kingdom of God upon you by the same Holy Ghost that He poured out 2,000 years ago when the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ got together, hallelujah, and gave to the church that wonderful glory, the only means by which Christ Jesus could be revealed and represented through our lives. If you're hungry, right now, it's the same Pentecost, the same encounter. Listen, my dear brother Yun said this. He said, once you've encountered God, it changes you forever. That encounter with Him leaves His mark upon you. All the things that you struggled with, all of the uncertainties, trying to discover and find the will of God for your life, it's a thing of the past. You become stamped, branded with heaven in your soul and your passions. You don't go looking for yourself anymore. You find the life in Christ Jesus. I believe if there's anything the church of Jesus Christ needs here today is that they need to receive the life of Jesus Christ. His life, the life He displayed, the life that He fully gave to us when He poured out His blood at Calvary's cross, when he rose up from the dead, when He ascended up on high and poured out the power of the Holy Ghost. So right now, in the name of Jesus, that same life, that same glory, that same power, that same anointing, it's yours right now. It's yours right now for the receiving. It's yours right now for the asking. It's yours right now. Hallelujah. Because it's Father's will. All you have to do is agree with Him, and these things could be yours. What things? Everything, every good and perfect thing, everything that comes right out of the realms of His presence, everything that comes right out of the realms of His Holy Spirit, the ability to fully represent Jesus. Hallelujah. Let your fire fall on me. Lord, I want the fire of Your presence to fall on me. Lord, I receive this glory that's come down from heaven for me. Just lift your hands towards heaven. Just lift your hands towards heaven. It's so easy. Just now receive. So easy. Just receive every good and perfect thing. Just receive a life that is abundant and so full of everything that belongs to God. You'll never be the same. You'll never have another day of wondering what you're supposed to be doing. Right now, in Jesus' name, the fire of God comes upon you. The power of His authority and of His glory overwhelms you right now. Everything changes. The sin that is in your life, forsake it. Lay hold on the goodness of God. Lay hold on the righteousness which He's freely given to us. Lay hold on the purity and the beauty of living in His ways. Right now, those of you who have been, maybe you have addictions in your life. You've had things you can't get past. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I set you free, and it's just that easy. It's just that easy. I've had alcoholics and heroin addicts and others come to me and said, when we were in the medium, it was like something that was always in my life was ripped out of me. Yeah, that's what the Holy Spirit is here to do. He's here to rip it right out of you. So it just won't even be there anymore. whatever the problem is, whatever the situation is, whatever the doubt, whatever the hurt, whatever the pain, whatever the unforgiveness, whatever the offense, right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I set you free. You stepped into this place here today to encounter Jesus Christ, and I tell you in the name of Jesus Christ, you go free. No longer to be held in sin or its bondage. No longer to be held under the power of death and its domain. But now to step into the light, the transforming power of Jesus Christ. Step forward into the glorious reign of Jesus in your life and in your heart. What a great salvation. Just lift your hands towards heaven and just tell the Lord you thank Him for His great salvation. I want you to just pray this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I thank You for Your precious blood that has washed me, that has cleansed me from every stain of sin. Lord, I recognize that You're the deliverer. You delivered me from a sin-cursed world. You delivered me from the reign of darkness, from the law of sin and death, that I might live my life in You. And Lord, I count Your life better than my life. I want Your life. I surrender myself to be led by the Holy Ghost, to be taught by You. From this day forward, I give myself to learning what only You, the Holy Spirit, can teach me. And Lord, wherever You lead me, I'll go. I want to shout about it. I want to tell about it. I want to be able to fully represent You. I want to show the love that You've shown again and again. When I meet someone who's sick, Lord, I want Your power to heal them. When I meet someone who's oppressed by the devil, Lord, we want Your power to deliver them. Every dimension of Your love that sets men free, we desperately want. We desperately need the power to turn men from darkness to light, from the powers of Satan over to Your domain, over to Your power, over to Your glorious reign. So we receive right now the power that You've given. We receive it right now. This anointing, this mantle of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the very near future, I'm gonna get Brother Yun back here, and I'm gonna let him. We're gonna set it up where he'll just have freedom to do a Chinese house church meeting. I'll tell you, unless you've been to China, it'd be hard for you to understand what I'm saying. But to kind of quantitate it, I mean, it's a minimum kind of 6-hour thing. But every bit of it's good. I'm so blessed for the anointing that has been placed upon my dear brother's life, for all of the heavenly people of China, for the great and mighty work of divine grace that took place when The people of the Holy Ghost rose up at the beginning of the 20th century out of what's now North and South Korea, but North Korea, swept over into China by 2000 and by 1907. Such a great outpouring of God took place and began to make ready what God would then begin to do at the event of the Cultural Revolution. The great men that were raised up out of obscurity like Watchman Nee, and there's so many great names you've never heard, great men of God. And today there's more than 200 million Holy Ghost filled people. I was with one dear person. I mean, I know that Joshua, one of the leaders, we call him Joshua, one of the leaders of the house church, would be over, you know, responsible for millions and millions of people. They were talking to him about, you know, what they're going to do in northern Iraq, etc. He said, well, who's reaching ISIS? Challenged everybody. And his little brother, he was telling me one day, you know, we don't like to use the finances that God provides for us for food because we can see a miracle take place. And, I mean, the miracles, if I describe them to you, just it would be hard for you to even believe, so I'm just not going to do it right now. I'm just going to tell you that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever, and he's doing in the midst of his church what he's always been doing. I was standing in, I was on the 47th floor of one of the great hotels recently in Tokyo, Japan, in the greatest, largest city of the world, 25 million people. And I said to the Lord Jesus, I said, Lord, you look very small here. Satan is very big in this nation. You look very small here. I want you to help me understand why. Why is it there's a free society and they as bad off as the worst unreached people group nation I've ever been to? Why? And I went to bed just broken. I just busted up. And because I was doing a tour of churches at the time, ministering different churches across the whole nation of Japan. And early in the morning, about 5 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning is when everybody in China's praying. It's just a thing. It just goes on like that. 5 o'clock in the morning, the Holy Spirit spoke to me and said, well, the Lord always speaks to me with scripture. The Lord Jesus said to me, all power, all authority is given to me in heaven and earth. I'm looking for someone to agree. See, we'll make all authority belong to him in heaven. We'll make all authority belonging to him sometime in the future, but he's King of Kings. He already is. We have to step out of the realm of the earthly confines to agree with him of what's actually happening right now in an unseen realm called the kingdom. Elisha was able to see it, and thus he was able to cooperate with God, and the great miracles and signs and wonders of his day was able to be worked. Father, just looking for you and me to step out of the confines of that which we see and think and hear and begin to live by the power and the authority of his word. One of the things that when I first met Brother Yun, after he got out of prison, he said, listen, many people will operate and live in facts, but there's something that's higher than facts. It's called truth. Facts become irrelevant in the midst of truth. Facts that you can't walk on water become irrelevant. When the word of life says to you, walk across the water, happened in Indonesia, happened in the great revivals of Indonesia, and revivals we say, that we refer to as like a mighty wind. There's whole regions of the world right now just waiting to hear the gospel of Jesus, and we pray that you'll be willing to go. But you can't go until you're first endued with power from on high. Because the only people on the mission field that make any difference are those who are endued with power from on high. It's just true. I'm sorry. I just the way it is. I praise God for I got family members that are Baptist preachers, Christian Missionary Alliance preachers. My family just preachers. I mean, we just got it in our blood. But you know what? The reality of it is, everybody will agree that the fun begins in the book of Acts. That if you get to do book of Acts, you're having a good time. Hallelujah. So listen, there's no one excluded. Father's left no one out. He's opened up the door, Christ Jesus, to every person, says, come on in. I want to fill you. I want to empower you. And I want to send you. When I went to, when Brother Yin and Brother Shi sent me to Nanyang the first time, where's Brother Yin is from? He's from Nanyang. It's the Galilee of China. I said, Lord, if I go there and find a bunch of religious people, I don't even know what I'm going to do. I'm being so heartsick. I don't even know what I'm going to do. You cannot find religious people in China. It's hard to find religious people in China. They're just full of the Holy Ghost. They just so want God. Why? They're about the master's business. It's all about reaching the lost. It's all about reaching the lost. It's all about doing the works of Jesus. It's about all about the ministry of Jesus. And I'm praying for that move of the Spirit, that revival, that consecration, that commitment to once again come to the United States of America. And you know how it's going to come? Because the church will say to the Lord, come on in, King of Glory, take over. The church will say, Holy Spirit, we're not going to try to do it our way anymore. It's not going to be about our programs anymore. If we just get still, just have meetings like this. Maybe the meetings actually even begin like this. This is how many places in overseas where great revivals are taking place. It's just people getting before the Lord, getting real. It's not about merchandise. It's not about popularity. It's not about this thing and that thing. We've made so many different things a church that it doesn't. It's not about. The church is about the very being and person of Jesus Christ here on the earth. And when we just camp around that for a little while, something will happen. Huh? We will be lit up with, huh? With the fire of the Holy Spirit, with the very passions of the Lord Jesus. And you just won't be able to stay around too long. Huh? And when you go to the restaurant after the meeting, there's a glory glow about you. There's a pleasantness about you that people are going to ask. They're going to have to say, why are you so happy? They're going to see a joy that doesn't exist. They're going to see a peace that doesn't exist inside the system of the world. They're going to see a love. Father's love. Jesus' love. Yesu ani. Hallelujah. But we love you. We pray blessing upon your life in every dimension of your life. The blessing that I want you to grab a hold of today, know that it's yours if you desire, is the blessings of being blessed with all spiritual blessings. The blessings of being blessed with every dimension of knowing what is the height, the breadth, the length, the depth. To know the love of Christ which passes knowledge. There being filled, continually filled with all the fullness of God. What a life. That's the abundant life. That's the life of Jesus. We don't want anyone to be left out. We don't want the cares of this life, the deceitfulness of riches, the pleasures of this world to spoil you, to choke you. We want you to just be liberated today. Get your divine assignment. The Lord, I've watched as the Holy Ghost has been talking to so many people here. And then you'll look at the confines of why you can't do what God's called you to do, or you can't dream big to go and live the life of Jesus. But right now, in the name of Jesus, I cancel those things off you. Those imaginations, those logics, those reasonings of men, right now, in the name of Jesus, no longer will they rule your life. But you'll know how to bring into captivity every logic, every rational thinking of men. And go ahead and live by the word and do the word. Amen? Find a bunch of people around you. Hug them. Tell them that you love them. Bless them in Jesus' name. We'll be back here tonight at 6 o'clock. And I'll tell you, we'll take up where we left off. I promise you. Tonight at 6 o'clock, we'll take up where we left off.